Will you come from Köln in Germany? He is called Philippe Storz, and he will speak about open source backup with Barrios, an alternative to Bakula. Let's applaud Philippe.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you very much. Yes, I am one of the founders of the Barrios project, and in my talk I would like to tell you why we did, what is Barrios? Why we did a fork of Bakula, because forking is a lot of work, and usually if you have an open source project that develops normally, then you can just work with the normal project leader to get the project forward instead of forking it. Then I would like to show some feature highlights, what we made better than the original project. Then I would like to stress that we really do have a stringent open source philosophy in our project. And finally, of course, we are here to find also people that want to participate in the project, maybe by bringing in ideas, documentation, and code, of course, whatever is needed in an open source project. So first, what is Barrios? Barrios is a network-based multi-platform backup solution. It's a fork of Bakula. Bakula is, I think, well-known in the open source market and is, I think, the biggest open source backup product known. It's licensed under the AGPL, which is, of course, the same what the open source Bakula code already is. What we did with it is we did a lot of code cleanup of the original Bakula code, because there are a lot of things that we think are not needed anymore. And our complete source code is hosted at GitHub, so that everybody can download it. And that's it. Why did we the fork of Bakula? I have some numbers of Olo. I think everybody knows Olo. They analyze the source code of open source projects. And if you have a look at the Bakula page, then you see first on very low activity, which is I think absolutely true, because I think the last commit was done more than a year ago. And if you see that in the last 12 months compared to the year before, you have 88% less commits and 57% less contributors. So that looks for like a project that more or less is dead. And you also can see here the plot of the commits per month, and you see that 2014 it expects that there will be nothing. So that's the reason. It's one of the reasons that we forked Bakula. A second reason is that there's a commercial part of Bakula, and this one is not open source anymore. So something that we think it's not acceptable, because usually if you have an open source project, you bring your contribution to it because you know it still stays open, and if somebody then takes it and makes another product of it, or you just have an open core product, that's no open source anymore. what's the goals of our fork? We want to have it 100% free software, so we absolutely promise that we will not do something like they do. So our code will always be completely open. We want to have a continuous development so that the project is not dead but alive and working, and we adapt to the needs that are out there at customers and as users. We try to be compatible to Bakula as far as possible, at least in the beginning, because there's already a relatively big installation base out there, and if we want to if we want people to use our project, of course it must be easy to switch to our project. So that's the reason why we try to at least have a smooth transition to our project, and that's something that is definitely easy doable today. What else we did is we cleaned up the configuration engine, because everybody that used Bacula knows that it's quite complicated to set up. There's a lot of options to set, and we try to clean up what has to be configured, what not, and what has what can be already set with a default that is somehow how do you say it? Yeah, logical, or most people need it in that way. Next, I would like to explain some feature highlights that we have and that Bacula does not offer. One of them is the SDSD replication. So SD stands for storage daemon. The Bacula and the Barrios system consists of three types of programs or daemons that are running. The intelligence lies in the director daemon. The file daemon is what other backup software vendors call client. And the storage daemon is the daemon is a part of the software that writes data to storage devices, for example tapes or disks, and reads it back on restore. What we are now able to do is we can replicate a backup done to one storage daemon over the network to another one, which enables us to copy it over to another building or something, which Bacula is not able to. On Bacula, you have the restriction that the two storages that you want to migrate from and to have to be connected to the same storage daemon computer, so it's only more or less possible to replicate it locally. Second new feature that we have in Barrios, and one of those I think are most important and helps administrators very much to use it, is the so-called passive client. The usual way of initiating a backup goes that way. The director contacts the storage daemon and tells the storage daemon that there will be a backup soon from the file daemon. Then the file daemon is contacted and told to which storage daemon to send the data, and the file daemon then initiates the connection to the storage daemon. This has a lot of drawbacks. One is, if you have a firewall or a NAT device, then you cannot directly access the storage daemon from the file daemon, but you need to create an additional port forwarding or things like that. Also, often in the companies, you have the problem that the file daemon outside or behind the firewall does not have the same name resolution, which then which then leads to a file daemon that cannot connect to the storage daemon. With the passive client option, we simply reversed the initiation of the data channel. So that means that now, instead of the file daemon connecting through the firewall to the storage daemon, the connection is set up the other way around. And that solves all the problems that we had before. This means that the file daemon does not need any name resolution anymore. And the firewall device does not need any extra configuration, so it's much easier for setup. A third feature that we have in Barrios is that we support the LTO drive's hardware encryption. Since LTO version 4, every tape drive has an included hardware encryption option. So everybody that has a modern LTO drive has the opportunity already in his hardware. And we are now able to use it. So you can, at full speed, encrypt your backups on tapes. Barrios is able to create and manage all those, all what is needed to use it. So every tape is encrypted with a tape-specific key. What is our open source strategy? So the whole software is AGPL version 3 licensed. The founders of the Barrios project all are long how do you say, for a long time already are working in the open source business, so we like open source very much, and we think that's the right way to do things. We do not have any venture capital, which means that we can decide ourselves what we want to do and what we do not to do, and we are not driven to make a certain amount of money in a certain amount of time. So that's what we see in other companies that have venture capital. They are driven just to make money, and they don't do the right decisions in their project. As already said, the source code of Boreos is on GitHub. It's on github.com/Boreos. So everything that we have in our project is there, so you can check it out and look into it. The source code is there. We have also regression tests on the source code that we run. Those are also in a sub-branch of our repository, and the documentation is also there. So everything is open. I think what we also have is Doxygen is a source code documentation tool, and we automatically run it on our source code, so that if somebody wants to dive into the code and see what it does or what is called from where, you can easily get used to the code by reading the documentation. So I hope that somebody of you, some people are interested in our project, and if you want to contribute to our project, you can go to the Boreos.org website. There's a how-to article where most things are explained, where you can contact us. We have two users and a development group on Google Groups. We have a bug tracker on bugs.boreos.org, and the source code is at GitHub. Yeah, if I will answer, of course, now questions as long as I have time for that. But
yeah, you have small time.
Of course, we are here. We have a stand in Building K, Level 2, where you can come over and talk to us. And of course, everybody that's wearing a T-shirt like I do is part of our project, so you can ask them anytime. Two of them are sitting there, so just ask us. Okay, I'm through. So, questions, please.
Yes. What is the state of B-pipe in Boreos?
What do you mean with state? We have it. It's compiled
and
in the packages.
Does it work? Are there success stories of B-pipe?
Yes, it works.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah.
Another question? We have another question.
Hi. So I'm very curious about the performance of Boreos. Can you tell me something about it? Do you have benchmarks or metrics? How it performs on a great scale?
So what we do, I have a tape tuning white paper. We tested the tape speeds, and the standard block size of Bacula is very slow, and if you increase the block size, it gets much faster. And on the website of Boreos, there are all the tests that I did and the analysis of that.
Can you how is it with the throughput of the network? Can you fill that?
Sorry,
the network throughput. Can you tell me something about that?
Sorry, did not...
The throughput through the network. Throughput. The network, yes.
The network throughput is as fast as the network works, so it's not limited by Boreos itself. Usually the client is not fast enough to find the files and to send them over the network, but Boreos itself is not the network bottleneck usually.
I have one unrelated question, if that is possible. So how do you solve the directories with a million of files and you need to backup them, like a million of small files? I think you know the problems with that.
Yeah, if it gets too big right now, in the end, it's we do the enumeration of the files. We just call a systems call in the end, and if that takes too long, we cannot do nothing about that. So that's we don't have a ready solution for that.
Okay, thank you.
No problem.
There has been a nice feature request list on the Bacula website for sitting for years without anything moving on it. One of the two things are actually related to the performance issues that the person over here asked about. One is the multi-threaded file daemon for reading up the files from the file system. When you have large repositories with small files, you're simply not saturating the underlying storage device. Another one is to be able to spool and despool concurrently. At the moment, the system simply just sit around waiting for pausing data from the client while it's spooling to tape. Are there any plans to do changes in these areas?
Right now, not concretely, but we in the bug tracker we also have feature requests. So if you have ideas of things that should be done better, please file them there.
Thank you for your talk.